Oh, Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone. She looks like my girl off Jerry McGuire. You know, just, what's that bitch's name? Her name's Bella.
Yeah,
what's your
name?
Yeah. I like her. Yeah.
I like her.
I don't know what's that called. Turn to East Middle, right square of
Scarborough Boulevard. Oh, I got you. Y'all go read a secret book.
What you got?
Jack Brown? Started 2-1.
So, Israel 2-1. He said unto me, Son of Man, stand upon thy feet, and I will speak unto thee. The Spirit entered into me with his back of me, and set me upon my feet.
Israelite.
So you knew Israelite.
Am I?
Yeah, what's the
first? I'm just
looking. You started smiling like
that.
She's like, oh, that's them. Yeah. That's a girl.
Go around me, son.
There. She's struggling.
You saw you. Okay,
alright, we'll go book it up. Sorry.
Back unto me and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that's back unto me. And he said unto me, Son of Man, I send thee to the children of Israel, rebellious nation that have rebelled against me. They and their fathers have transgressed against me, even unto this very day.
Yeah, to this very day, because our people are rebellious. They don't want to hear the laws of the Lord. They don't want to hear the law that says thou shalt not commit adultery. They don't want to hear that. They don't want to hear thou shalt not eat the swine's flesh. You know what I mean? They don't want to hear that you ain't supposed to celebrate Christmas. You know what I'm saying? The men, you know what I mean? They don't want to listen to the laws of the Lord. That's why he got up out of there. He's like, oh, we're getting out of here. Go ahead, read that again.
He said to me, Son of Man, I send thee to the children of Israel, to a rebellious nation that have rebelled against me. They and their fathers have transgressed against me, even unto this very day.
Yeah, you don't want to bring that adultery up with us. They don't want to bring up that adultery either. You mentioned adultery, that's what I cut your boy's beard. He had to get him out of here. Go ahead.
For they are impudent children and stiff-hearted, and I do send thee unto them, and thou shalt send to them, thus saith the Lord God, and they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear.
Right, because we're supposed to say it to them, but we come in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, you know what I'm saying? And we tell them that we come in the name of the Lord. Go ahead.
For they are rebellious house guests.
Oh yeah, so they gonna know there's been a prophet among them. And that's why we've been saying that we're prophets. You know what I mean? What else did the prophet say? Hold on a second. Let's turn the button. This shit's too loud. Yeah, go ahead.
Thou son of man, be not afraid of them, be afraid of their words.
Yeah, so you ain't supposed to be afraid of these people, man. You know, you hear them talk and they sound all evil. They talk a lot of shit. Like you was just saying, right? You pointed right there. They talk a lot of shit, right? Our people, they talk a lot of shit. But they just full of shit. That's all it is. They talk a lot of shit because they full of shit. Go ahead.
No barriers and thorns be with thee, and thou dost dwell among scorpions. Be not afraid of their words, nor be dismayed at their looks, but they be a rebellious house.
Yeah, so we live among scorpions. Even they come up there and stink your ass, you know what I'm saying? That's why you gotta watch yourself when you're around these people. Go ahead.
Thou shalt speak my words to them, whether they will hear or whether they're forbear, for they are most rebellious.
Right, so we're going to teach the Bible whether you hear or whether you don't hear, we just don't care. We just gonna do it anyway. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
But thou, son of man, hear what I said to thee. Be not thou rebellious like the rebellious house. Open thy mouth and eat that I give thee. And when I looked and behold, and hand was sent unto me, and lo, a roll of a book was therein, and he spread it upon me, and it was written where fin was out, and there was written there in limitation, morning and woe.
Yeah, so that roll, yeah, right, you supposed to eat the roll, and the roll represents this truth, this word, this wisdom, you know what I mean?
Chapter 3.
Yeah, you might as well just keep going.
Ezekiel 3, verse 1. Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest, eat this roll, and go speak unto the house of Israel. So I opened my mouth, and he called me to eat that roll, and he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat, and fill thy mouth with this roll that I give thee. Then did I eat it, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness. And he said unto me, son of man, go get thee into the house of Israel, and speak with my words to them. For thou art sent to a people of a strange, for thou art not sent to a people of a strange speech, and of a hard language, but to the house of Israel, not to many people of a strange speech, and hard language, whose words thou couldst not understand.
Right, that's right. We coming to Israel, we speaking the same language that they speak. Because sometimes people, they get offended at the way we talk. We just speaking the same language of our people. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Surely, had I sent thee to them, they would have hearkened unto thee. But the house of Israel will not hearken unto thee, for they will not hearken unto me, for all the house of Israel are impure and hard-hearted.
So yeah, so the Lord already told us, you know, that Israel, they're not going to hearken unto us. They're going to listen. But you got to go tell them anyway. You know what I mean? That's when the Lord brings that destruction, there ain't going to be no excuse. That's funny though, the Lord told you that they're not going to listen to you. You know, it's funny, man. The Lord said Israel was a stiff-necked, what, an impudent and stiff-necked people. What did it say,
stiff-hearted or stiff-necked?
Yeah, hard-hearted. You know, these people are just, man, they got no sense in them, man. They don't want to listen to nothing, man. They don't want to do nothing that's good. They just want to, you know, be assholes and jackasses. And adulterers, faggots.
Shit, hold up on the motherfuckers that conversation we have to breathe and shit. You know we don't do anything. You can't tell him nothing because he ain't trying to listen anyway.
Oh, he got a degree, yeah. He's high and mighty.
Yeah. Motherfucker just got his high school diploma.
All I had to do to get my high school diploma was just show up.
That's all you gotta do pretty much is show up to school every day.
They'll just give it to you.
His hair is had it out for my black hair. This Gene Harris, there he is, man. That was evil calling, man. Evil.
So he's your principal?
Yeah.
Gene Harris?
Gene Harris,
yeah. Wow.
I told you before, man.
I think you just say something.
Yeah, I went to, my old fucking, my junior and senior, especially like about a second semester, my senior year, man, I kept going to the motherfucking guidance counselors and shit. Man, I need help, man. I'm tripping. I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? You know? Yeah. You know? I went to school every day. I ain't going to be home, so I went to school every fucking day. They did their part, conscious of part, you know, feed the beast, man. Make sure this amount fail. Make sure these Uncle Tom motherfuckers get through, you know.
Because we already know they all Freemasons and stuff.
Right.
They all got an agenda.
Right. Gene Harris.
Oh, we know because we already, hey, like that thing with the Hillary Clinton, the email leak, the WikiLeaks, how it went into her top advisor, got caught doing witchcraft. And they said they would take urine and feces and sperm and mix it with paint, make paintings out of it. They say that they said it was a magical painting.
That's crazy.
But if people at the highest offices do that, I mean, you know, everybody else is doing it too.
I saw a video when they was talking about when they was drinking the shit.
Yeah, they drinking it.
They was drinking the shit.
You know, they eating it.
Doing all kind of crazy shit with it, man. You know, but funny thing is, we come out here, we get give these stupid motherfuckers the truth. But you know what? They pick and choose what they want to use in their time. You know what I'm saying? They pick and choose.
Oh,
now,
hey.
This shit coming out now that these motherfucking elected officials are Satans, you know?
Yeah. They actually worship the devil. It's in the news.
Right.
About how they're into witchcraft. You know, some people are like, oh, that's cute. Like, I do that too.
Yeah.
That's why you can't get stupid motherfucker, man. Ain't an actual fucking witchcraft, and she's running for president.
She was a child sex trafficker.
Yeah, they said she raped a 12-year-old girl or something.
7, 7, 12. You know?
I believe it.
They know. Because they the ones that was... You know what?
It's just like when that the Speaker of the House, when the Speaker of the House is a third in command under the president, but a former Speaker of the House, Dennis Hassard, he got caught like raping little boys, and he actually is doing time over. So you know they're all doing that. You know what I mean?
Hell yeah. They started telling each other. Here it is, right here. This is Ecclesiastes, Sirach 21 and 27. When the ungodly curses Satan, he curses his own soul. Now, it's Satan's against Satan's, you know what I'm saying?
It
like,
is.
For example, you see the Alex Jones, the video of Alex, you know Alex Jones is a fucking Mason.
Yeah.
And here he is condemning other motherfuckers. Masons ain't nothing but Satan's.
Well, he'll tell you there's good Masons, though.
Right.
He said there's good Masons and the bad Masons.
Same thing, Farrakhan said the same shit.
Yeah.
Farrakhan, look, damn, they made a video together. They were in closed doors together.
Yeah, how do you
ain't
get
that kind of funny?
What's
that's
up?
Funny
yeah.
shit, you know?
Yeah, nobody gets interviews with Farrakhan.
Right. These motherfuckers are crazy, man. They on some other shit, man. Cause they telling each other. That's what you do when you lay in the bed with fucking Satan, man. Shit. Satan comes after your ass. That's beautiful though, man. That's just fucking beautiful, man. Well, that just shows ain't no loyalty amongst them motherfucking devils. You know, they supposed to take their secrets to the graves. Like they say, you know, take the secrets to the grave.
Yep. Yeah, with threat of getting your tongue cut out. But
that's deep though, man. That's deep how all this shit is coming out, man. What's up, man? All this shit is coming out, man. And you know when the motherfucking devil brings it out, everybody listens then.
They will listen when your crazy ass says it.
When the truth comes out, when the truth is followed. When scriptures is followed behind it, you know.
That's what I said, because it sounds crazy when we say a politician is a devil worshiper. But when this shit comes out in the news, you know, it's bugged out.
It's everywhere too, ain't it?
Yes. It's
witchcraft, they into child molestation.
Yeah, child molestation,
you know,
witchcraft.
On and on. And I'm telling you, that bombshell that's probably going to come out tomorrow is probably going to be videos. You know, it's probably going to be in the actual act. You never know,
and
man.
And each bombshell gets bigger and bigger. It's like they've been holding it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
America, a nation of goddamn devils. Now the world is starting to see.
Founded by devils and for devils.
Right. Iran been calling America the great Satan for how long? As long as we can remember. Now we're starting to see what Iran see.
Yep. Hey, cause like Ahmadinejad. Hey, I said that name in a minute.
That's your
boy.
Ahmadinejad is still in the scene. He ain't going nowhere.
Cause Mary, he said we don't have faggots in our country. He said we don't have that problem.
Shake that man's hand.
Yeah.
Like to shake that man's hand.
Yeah. What's up? You know Ahmadinejad? Hey, the Lord gonna come with them arrows, bro. Go ahead.
So they shall make their own tongues fall upon themselves. All that see them shall flee away.
Yeah, it's like their own tongue. They, you know what I mean? They get caught up in all their lies. Because if you a liar, it's hard not to get caught up in lies. Once you tell so many lies, it's hard to hold that weave of lies together. This is gonna fall apart. You know what I mean? Because, you know, a liar can't keep up with all of his own lies. And you see that with a liar. You be like, bro, you just lying to me.
No, I'm not. See the elected officials, you see their lies in the face of the show.
Yep.
They all got that same wicked push, man. All of them. They don't let people know.
They had lies straight through their teeth.
It right nothing. To the face. You just saw
them. And these people are cheering for them. You know what I mean?
This is the end of, man. The most controversial fucking president. This is shit, man. Nobody believes no one. No one trusts no one anymore. That's just nothing but Satan's kingdom.
He said he hold fast his name. What's the Lord's name? The Lord's name is not Lord. The Lord's name, the Father's name is Yahweh, and the Son's name is Yahweh Shah. It said we hold fast the name. It didn't say that you keep the name a secret, to go hide the name away, to give him a new name, call him Jesus Christ. Cause you ain't never gonna hear IUIC out of there professing the name of the Lord. They gonna be out there, you know what I'm saying? They all got Hebrew names, but they can't give the Lord a Hebrew name. But they call themselves by a Hebrew name. What kind of sense is that, man? That's asshole shit. Go ahead.
Even in those days wherein it was my faithful martyr who was slain where Satan dwelleth. That's America.
Yeah, we live in the kingdom of Satan. This is, I mean, the Church of Satan was founded in America. San Francisco, the Church of Satan was founded by Anton LaVey in America. So where else would the Church of Satan would be in the kingdom of Satan, wouldn't it? I mean, it's just logic, you know? Simple logic, bro. And now you hear some of the stories in the news every day about how they're going to have a satanic after school care or after school satanic after school lessons or whatever.
That shit being kickstarted, bro.
Yeah, bro, they got after school satanic workshops for children.
And it's very, very successful. And they got more and more kids signing up to do getting involved with it too. They must be doing something to make them, you know what I'm saying? You give a child some candy, it's gonna fall.
And then you add that with no Bibles are allowed in school, add that together with that. Add that together with Hillary Clinton making spiritual soup out of semen and blood and diarrhea and making art out of feces. What's that? But they ain't gonna be able to call themselves in the destruction plan. You know what I mean? Who does 911 call? When they get in trouble. Who do they call when they get in trouble?
Ghostbusters.
Oh, the Ghostbusters. Oh, the new Ghostbusters.
With the women. That motherfucking Ghostbusters was terrible.
It looked terrible. I refused to watch it.
Well, I had to watch it, man. Just to be a witness against
it. I just don't hate to be a witness against it. I don't want to lose pressure.
It was the worst shit. And first of all, two of them women are actually funny, man, but whoever wrote them, man. Totally fucked it up.
And they did that on purpose. That's all about the effeminization of America.
They want nothing but simple.
Yeah, it's just doing. Cause they keep putting up women as heroes in the movies now. Cause they're trying to put that effeminate spirit on these men out here. Yeah, the vibration of the woman, the spirit of a woman. That's why there's so many faggots and transgenders now. Now you got gender neutral people. They put soy in all the food. And soy has high levels of estrogen in it. And estrogen is not good for a man. Okay, that's something a woman needs. That's what makes a woman a woman. That's all up in your food. And there's nothing but homosexual vibrations being put out in the music. The famous, most famous rap song talking about skinny jeans. You know what I mean? What's that shit? The skinny jeans or whatever? Everybody's rocking that shit, but it's some faggot shit. That's what it is. Go ahead.
Yeah, what I mean by vibration is when you continuously broadcast something and people hear it, it carries on. That's what it means by vibration. You know what I'm saying?
Everything
just
operates
like
in vibration.
You put the fact of vibration in the air, everybody else becomes a fact.
Yeah, I mean, the word, the sound is made through vibration.
You did vibration. It's like some voice or something.
Yeah,
it hurts. It hurts. It's like a certain, I don't know how, like a certain number, it's going to make you vibrate.
Right. Different frequencies.
Certain frequencies.
The frequency. Yeah.
Triggers certain emotions.
When you're dealing with vibration, vibration goes through sight also. So what you see travels through sight also.
That's why we'll get a different reaction from me cussing you out than me speaking softly.
Right. Vibration. The eye sees spectrums and colors. That's what goes through vibration.
Everything is vibration.
Right.
Hey, that's some deep stuff. That's why scientists, they think
of shit. You don't know shit. That's why they walking the fuck off.
That's why the scientists think they can figure out the mind of the Most High. They come over that thing called string theory, by the vibrating string.
That's why you see a lot of scientists commit suicide.
Yeah, they do commit suicide. They get bugged out.
Every fucking time they commit assassination, like they push conspiracy type. I can't take it. Boom! Hold on, baby. I gotta take the kids out and you.
Because a lot of scientists, yeah, they go in as atheists and come out believers. Yeah, because you know a lot of Gates is a scientist.
That's the main scientist.
Yeah,
he's
the main.
You got Esau lurking behind him taking the credit. Though.
Yeah, like Albert Einstein. He worked up in the patent office, stealing everybody's patent. You know what I mean? When the real genius was Nikola Tesla.
Do
this. Go ahead. We went off the rails. That's all right, though, because you always got scoffers, you know what I mean? Go ahead. You know, we ain't speaking of the truth. Yeah, because that, you know.
Who wouldn't want to hear the truth, man? How amazing is that?
For real.
Except the pastor. We know why they don't.
Talking about their hustle.
Yeah. Amos 9 and 8. For blow, I will command. No, Amos 9 and 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord power are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth.
Yes, yeah, so the Lord's going to destroy America from off the face of the earth. That's going to happen. Y'all talking thinking Donald Trump is going to make America great again. Hey, look, bro, America's about to go down like Humpty Dumpty, bro. And you ain't never gonna be able to put it back together. You know what I mean? Once that destruction hit, that's it. It's a wrap. It's a done deal. Go ahead.
And I will utterly destroy the house. Saying that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, saith the Lord. Although I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations, like as corn sifted in the sea, yet shall not please the least.
Right, because the Lord's bringing that fire. And this is that harvest time, too. So, like the scripture said, the Lord will not utterly destroy all of Jacob. Because two-thirds of Israel got to die in this fire. And two-thirds of our people, they're going to be destroyed. But the Lord's going to save a third. He's going to save the elect. And it also says that the Lord is going to sift Israel from among all nations. Because the Israelites have been scattered among all nations. That's why you're supposed to teach the gospel to all nations, because Israel scattered among all nations, as stated all through the Bible.
Well, that's simple. Ain't gonna be no independent women.
Oh, hell no.
No independent black woman when we get delivered.
Nah. She's gonna be independent. She don't need no help.
Right, she don't need no help.
She don't need no deliverance. She already saved. She can save herself, bro.
Can't get these black women. Don't make sense. That's just some funny shit. Independent black woman. And the more and more they act like they're independent on shit, the more I'm starting to like it, man. So we know the end. We see the end.
Yeah, you
know
we see the end.
We see the shame that's gonna smack her, man. Because I fuck with a bitch talk shit that she mad.
Because at the same time too, it's like, damn, you kind of pity him in a way because it's like, damn, man, it must be really bad to be so retarded. That's gotta be an awful feeling. You know what I mean? Could you imagine walking around in darkness, just being dumb as hell all day? That's gotta be an awful place to be.
Oh, let me get this priest going. 10. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword, which say the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us. That's that black woman. She's
yeah.
Like you said.
Right. Well, that's all bullshit you talk about. Mm-hmm. That's that bullshit.
Well, I love Jesus. I'm married to Jesus.
Yeah. He was not a man of the Lord.
You mean tell me you and the people that fucking stole the breakfast ass pastor at the same time?
They're comedians.
Yeah, it's funny. The evil shall not overtake the prevent. In that day will I raise up the tabernacle of David that is fallen. And close up the
yeah, this right here is the tabernacle of David right here. You know what I'm saying? We done set up the tabernacle. We up in the tabernacle. And y'all's tabernacle is like the outhouse. That's their tabernacle. You know that outhouse that they've been servicing a few months? You got a mountain of shit coming out of the pool. Yeah, what did it?
Yeah.
Adultery.
Where the scorpion is
playing.
That's
the snake.
The tabernacle is supposed to be a place where you feel safe.
Yeah. The sanctuary.
Yeah.
That's a holy place. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like a temple.
Yeah.
It's really where the tabernacle. The temple is within you. You know what I'm saying? You're
so they don't have no they don't know what Jesus is, so it's open up.
Yeah, right. But if you got a holy temple, you ain't supposed to let everything in the script. There's laws in the scriptures about what you're supposed to let in the temple. Hey, just I got a precept for that. Hey, that's a good point. Look,
everything. Anything and everything. Like I told the dude the other day, he told me his friend was murdered. He said he loves him. No, he said he can't judge him, he can't even say he's doing wrong to him. Now look at that motherfucker like that, 12 years.
Hey, let me read this. Hey, look at precept for that real quick. 2 John 1:9. Whosoever transgresseth and abideth not in the doctrine of Christ, which is Mashiach in Hebrew, hath not God. He that abideth in the doctrine of Christ, he hath both the Father and the Son. If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed. For he that biddeth him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deeds.
Right. You ain't supposed to be looking at a motherfucker and at least thinking your mind, motherfucker, a piece of shit.
Yeah, like,
I think we'll come out of your mouth and have a beautiful day. Have a blessed day. That's what they expect.
Yeah, they be like, God bless you.
Have a blessed day, brother.
What's up? Because the scriptures don't say to bless people like that. We get that in is that Deuteronomy? Does curse be this guy if they do this and that? You're supposed to curse him, not bless him.
In that day, I will raise up the tabernacle of David and the storm that throws up the priest there. And I will raise up his food and I will build his house in the days of old. And we're giving y'all the blueprint. You know, how we build the days of old. You know, following after the how much in your house are. Like it's going on. Can't allow, like us, for example. We don't allow any motherfucking body part that don't start pushing the word out. You know, we push the word, bring a nigga in, they shout in the background, you know, throwing up their signs and shit. Or screaming out their block. You know what I mean?
Yeah, niggas, that bullshit.
Niggas will bring niggas amongst us, you know? And the Lord don't, you know, he ain't with no niggas. And he ain't with, and he's not coming to save black people.
Yeah, because this, We about wisdom and knowledge and truth.